We're going to take a break here, but Fezzy, I want to drag you into the show today. I want this to be the Ron and Fez show today. Ron Bennington and Fez Watley. What's on your mind?
Something going on over in Russia.
All right, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. You don't want to miss this. Fez is talking about the Ruskies. As soon as we get back, Ron and Fez show. Fez Watley, you got a big story for us out of Russia.
Out of the country of Russia, over the past weekend, they got rid of two of their time zones. They have like 11 time zones there.
Well, is it up to them?
I guess they're allowed to do what they want with their country.
And but there's also international time zones, right?
Yeah. Well, they said that this would help transportation and communication by getting rid of these two time zones.
I don't know if that's true. How would it?
I guess it gets more people on the same page.
But that doesn't make any sense. It's still the difference in sunlight, no matter what you call it.
I think it's Russia just showing that, you know what, we can control time as well. Where they're just, it's like, we can do it, so we're going to. No matter what happens.
Well, you can call it whatever you want, but it doesn't mean that it's set for the international time zone.
So I was thinking, with the time zones here, I don't think I would like living on West Coast time. Where you knew that things had already happened. Like, let's say the Lost finale had played on the East Coast. And you're just waiting for it, like a wave coming in from the East, to finally see it. Knowing that it had already happened would drive me nuts.
Well, does it bother you to know that the Lost finale was actually shot 6 months before? I mean, that's when the wave starts.
No, I can deal with that.
It's only when it's released that bothers you.
Right, yeah. Knowing that other people had seen it already.
Mm. Now, it bothers you that people could see other things before you. Like a movie comes out before you can see it.
No.
Just TV for you.
Yeah, it would just be, I think it would be mostly around TV.
Okay.
Well, you might adapt, though. Consider that, because I'm sure Los Angeles people realize that now, and they're just cool with...
They go Twitter dark. I find it odder more that if something that is supposed to play live runs late, Saturday Night Live, knowing that it already happened, seems like an odd thing to call it Saturday Night Live. And then beyond that, of course, is, you know, the Today Show obviously doesn't start at 4 o'clock in the morning in L.A. But the weirdest for me is that the ball drops in New York City, everyone yells Happy New Year, and the people in L.A. watch that, even though it's 9 o'clock at night.
Yeah, that doesn't make sense, because if you were to have a heart attack, you know, you'd be dead on December 31st. So why you're celebrating the next year is strange.
I don't even understand that part of it. I didn't get the heart attack.
Well, you're celebrating New Year's Day when, if you're in California, when the ball drops in New York. However, you have a heart attack at 9:01.
Let me just ask you, where's the nature zone?
It's coming. It'll be here, right?
Did he leave the building for it?
He
wasn't supposed to. It's in our fucking candy machine.
Oh, okay. And so Pepper's going to get it from the vending machine. We thought it was a power bar. So.
No. It's the one here. The nature zone.
Okay, we thought power bar, so we went to the Duane Reade, but you're going to get it within seconds.
Oh, God. That's fucking crazy talk.
The heart attack thing just weirded me out, where you saw the new year arrive in New York City, but you're dead the year before. In the previous year. You just totally freaked me out now, Dave.
Yeah, isn't that weird to think about?
It's just bizarre. And would you get used to it? Let's say there was just one time zone for the entire world. Would you get used to that, where someone's having their noon in the middle of the night?
I don't know. I do know if I was in... I'd love to be in West Coast time for, like, sports. Like, the World Series would be old school. It'd be on at 6 o'clock at night, rather than 9 o'clock. To me, the way the World Series should be. That would be fucking awesome. I would really appreciate that.
See, I think with, like, football, I think the East Coast time is perfect. You can sleep in on a Sunday, get yourself together, have some breakfast or brunch, and then the game start.
Yeah, but the game starts because they're starting for the East Coast. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
We just don't happen to live on the right thing. things are set up for New York. You understand what I'm saying, Phil?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So this just doesn't happen to work out that it works there. They go, when can we put the games on and have always on TV for the people at home? Games used to start at all fucking, you know, whenever the local people wanted it.
Yeah.
Here's Mike in Baltimore. You're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Fez, you're concerned about time zones. Don't you realize that a bomb just went off on a train this morning, killed 30 people?
No kidding.
Russia?
I thought that's when he said big news out of Russia. I'm like, Fez Watley, reading the front page.
I never heard the terrorist story.
You know, well, you have newspapers, right?
Yeah.
What's on the front page today?
I didn't look at a newspaper. I just looked online. I didn't see anything.
Go to the front page of any fucking newspaper online. You'll see that story. Here is, well, let's go over here too, I guess. You have no name. You're on Ron Fez Show.
Fez, man?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just want to bring up, you guys talking about time zones, and Fez is bringing it up. Arizona in this country doesn't even adapt to anything. They half the year they're on Pacific time, and half the year they're on mountain time. They don't abide by the daylight savings.
But internationally, aren't they still in the same time zone? You know what I mean? Like, you could call it whatever you want, but I think that those things are set up on an international fucking thing.
I always thought so, too. I thought it was like the world agreed on it. I didn't think that all of a sudden, you know, we could say Milwaukee's on East Coast time. It doesn't make sense.
Brian, California, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, I just spent my first New Year's out here in L.A., and actually at midnight when the ball dropping, I realized I looked up at the screen, and they replay the ball dropping in New York at midnight here. They don't even do their own fucking thing.
Give a shit at midnight if I lived in L.A.
Yeah, I had no idea. I expected my own little, you know, type of L.A. Celebration or whatever, and I looked up at the TV screen, and it was New York, and I was like, what the fuck? Why did, you know, this is weird.
Kevin, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, India just has one time zone. They're actually a half hour different than all the other countries. So you go there, it's 8.5 hours different.
Well, the reality of this, time doesn't mean anything. It doesn't fucking mean anything. We're just using something so you know what time to meet me for lunch. That's the only reason why we have time. No one used to be that fucking interested in it. That's why you would sit here. I'll see you around noon, because it would be easy enough. All right, there's noon. It's up in the center. Gotcha.
The Newfoundland, where my family's from, they're an hour and a half ahead of us here in New York. I don't know where the half hours come in. You would think, let's keep it simple, keep it hourly. But they go for the half hour there.
Here's Rob in Garden City.
Hey, what's up, guys? Yeah, I lived in Arizona for 4 years, and whenever the ball would drop during New Year's, they would show it at midnight. They would just show us a taped version of it.
That's hideous.
They wouldn't just show it at like 9 o'clock.
I would not fucking count down with people from 3 hours before.
Oh, yeah, no, it's very weird because while those people is like in the city now already headed home and the garbage trucks are out there cleaning up the garbage, where they're just watching a taped version of it. It's like, you know, it's like almost like, you know, time travel in a way. You're seeing shit that like...
How hard would it be to just drop a cactus and have your own little celebration?
Yeah, I don't get it.
Well, the only celebration, here's the thing, the celebration was always a New York celebration. Not everybody in the world, you know, gave a shit about it. It was the ball dropping in New York. That's like saying, why can't you have your own New York holiday where you live? Stupid. Same thing in this country. We think of Christmas, snow, city sidewalks, shopping. That was always the New York holiday. Most of the country never had that holiday. Most of the people wouldn't even fucking know White Christmas. Why should they? Or sidewalks and shopping and fucking Santa's on the corner. Most of the people were farmers. Instead, though, they're like, they adopted the fucking New York holiday. Here's Adam. You're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Ron. What if you were born on the East Coast and you end up moving to the West Coast later in... And at 10 o'clock at night, you're celebrating New Year's and you died. How old would you actually be?
I don't think you're any age once you're dead. You're a zero at that point again. It's a restart.
Very confusing.
Brian, Vegas, home run Fez.
Hey, this time discussion has me thinking, does anybody wear a watch anymore now that, you know, we're digitized with our cell phones?
Look, no. I don't know anybody who wears a watch. It's a retarded thing. You just actually, wait, let me check my phone to see what time it is.
It's more like jewelry now. Like, you know, a lawyer will wear a watch, but that's just to give him standing.
Yeah.
You know, it's not about time where it used to be.
And the digital watches that were so big, they went away quick.
Well, those people
went back to just a regular face clock on their wrist.
It's because those digital things were pieces of junk. I mean, those were shitty watches.
Yeah, the Swatch did not last as long as you wanted it to.
Despite the fact of being able to exchange wristbands with it for any outfit or occasion.
I love how you say outfit. I never hear another man say outfit. I'll never hear Hicks say, I'm getting a new outfit, or what do you think of my outfit? Fez will use that word, though.
Well, yeah, if you got, you know, your pants and shirt combo, whatever else goes with it, that's an outfit. I don't think if there's another word for it.
You know, there's no men use it, though? Just you?
I guess so. I never
Women
thought.
Say it.
You guys like my new blouse? Well, how's it looking?
Large.
It's double XL, actually.
All comes back to weight with you, doesn't it, Watley? You are your mom. You are your mom.
I'm wearing an outfit today for Passover. I got to celebrate that fucking Jew holiday today. I got to go to Westchester, Jew Central.
That means no bread all week. Now, it starts at sundown, right?
Yeah, I got to be there at 6 o'clock for some kind of sundown. Then it's something about plagues, and we're going to be acting out plagues that Moses had to go through, so... I don't know what the hell these people do, man. You might as well say these people put up Stonehenge. I know nothing about Jews and their rituals.
Why don't you learn?
I'm going to tonight. Tonight's the first Jewish thing I've ever done in my entire life. I mean, we lit the menorah, but that seemed like rinky-dink bullshit. This is a real thing.
You're in now, dude. Now they got you. Now this becomes the yearly thing.
Well, I was wondering about this. How many times do you have to visit like a family before you think you've put in enough time to get into their will? Because that's basically what we're doing it for.
Generally, never count on any of that money.
Okay.
I've always found out that when people die, you got to come up with cash to bury them.
Oh, all right. But what if they have lots of money?
Who is it?
It's, like, grandparents on the other side of the family. My in-laws.
They got any other closer kids?
They have, not really. They have, and they don't really have any proper grandchildren. We're giving them their first proper grandchildren.
Do they have kids of their own? How many kids?
They have, two kids, two daughters.
You're not getting anything. The daughters will get it.
That's how it works. Grandkids rarely get something if their parents are still alive.
I didn't know that. Oh, fuck. So, because I thought, like, you know, we're putting a lot of time in with these people. Going
How much
up,
time you put in?
I've gone up to Westchester quite a bit. And it's a very far drive when you have to go up to Westchester. Maybe not from the city, but then when you have to go back down to Jersey.
I understand.
It's like a three-hour drive.
But you think I'm going to give somebody a couple $100,000 because they took a trip? I don't get it.
Well, we're bringing in, you know.
And how old are these people?
I'd say mid to late 70s.
You're looking at another, these days, 15, 20 years anyway. They can't count on that money.
They love or it's actually their great-grandchildren. They love them. So I figured they'll give us some money to raise them properly, and then we can, you know, take that money from their college fund and use it on, like, cars and shit.
Ask them straight out.
Okay. That's not a bad idea.
Stop playing games. Ask him tonight during Jew dinner.
I was going to say, is it appropriate to ask?
Yeah.
Should I ask before dinner or after?
After.
Okay.
Right now, you are probably at best getting some sort of knick-knack.
Oh, yeah. I don't want that. I don't want that shit at all. I want some fucking hard-earned Jew cash.
Some sort of ceramic clown or something.
How much money are they worth, you think? $10 million?
Yeah. We'll go in that direction.
then you should be fucking moving up there. You should be right next door. For $10 million, you ought to be there. You shouldn't leave it up to chance.
It's a nice area. I'll tell you that much. Westchester is beautiful, but I don't know.
Brian, you're in Run of Fez.
Hey, Dave, Passover is meant for you because you have to drink, like, during the service, like 4 cups of wine or something like that. I don't know. It's been a while, but it's part of the ritual where you drink the wine and you do all this shit, but it's perfect. You get the drink.
I love lamb. Is this the Passover that celebrates lamb?
No, there's like a lamb bone, but besides that, you just get to drink 4 cups of wine. You should be happy with that.
Yeah, I'm happy about that, but can I drink Guinness?
You can't eat bread all week.
Yeah, I mean, what the fuck? I'm a bread man.
Are you going to eat bread this week?
It's not that little shitty communion where you get to take a sip and have a wafer. You get to have a meal and 4 cups of wine.
Dude, he can have 4 cups of wine any meal he wants. Why act like this is something to fucking celebrate?
And that shitty wafer is Jesus, mister.
You basically just called the Lord a shitty wafer.
Really? We're Catholics in here. Well, except for Fez. Fucking transubstantiation. Look it up. It's not a fucking mento. Guy thinks it's a
scientific fact. It turns into a dead man's flesh.
Exactly.
Period.
I'm just.
That's why kids get abused.
I can't wait to do like the Jewish prayers, you know, and join in with that shit. All that, like, you know, basically, it's like speaking in tongues.
And tonight you're leaving a chair open for Elijah. There's a good chance a person could just show up and say, I'm Elijah.
Oh, sort of like a Saint Nick gimmick.
Yeah, it is. It's like a cheap Saint Nick.
At your Seder dinner.
I see. What, am I supposed to leave cookies and milk for this Elijah?
Now, Easter is this coming weekend. The holiday with the worst candy attached to it.
Where was our vacation? Don't we always take Easter week off?
When Easter is usually in April, further along.
So, why wouldn't we take it for Easter? Don't you always go home for Easter?
I've done that, yeah. I don't know, it just didn't come up. This was one of those quick Easters where, like, Ash Wednesday started really quick in February, so it's just one of those quick Lents.
I did bring it up, I think, a couple times. Our Easter vacation was coming up.
Did anybody answer you?
I don't think so.
I did. Easter's a big thing in the McDonald family, but, well, you know, I'm okay with it.
I know. We always take an Easter vacation.
Yeah. I thought so, too, because then, like, my brothers come up, so we usually have that week after Easter, and I spend time with my family, but that's all right. We got fucking Christmas and all that shit, too.
They had an Easter egg hunt on Roosevelt Island this weekend, and it was just seeing those kids with those Cadbury eggs. Worst candy ever.
He's got a premise that he's getting to no matter what we're saying about the vacation. All right, roll with it, big man.
The Cadbury egg, you should not have a candy that burns your throat. I don't even know what that cream part is in the middle, the fake yolk and white of the egg. It actually burns the throat. It makes your eyes water.
I love those.
You're going to actually make Jeremy Coleman mad about that because he was bragging about Cadbury or somebody like that. Wasn't that the best chocolates in the world? Aren't they British?
Yeah.
Because I said you're not known for sweets over there. He got indignant.
Yeah. Well, the British people and the Irish people hate American chocolate. They don't.
It's all sugar.
Yeah. And they think that their chocolate is richer and really chocolate tasting.
How can you hate sugar? It's deliciously sweet.
Right, but you can have it in so many things. We want it in everything. So everything we get kind of tastes the same. We don't have a chocolate taste in this country. We weren't raised in it.
Our chocolate is like a Big Mac for, you know, the way, like, you're supposed to eat a regular hamburger.
Right.
But we have, you know, Big Macs. That's the way our chocolate is to those English and Irish people.
Right.
I've heard that so many times that they just shit on. I'm like, you really are shitting on a fucking Hershey bar? That really doesn't represent. And they're like, no, Hershey bar sucks.
All the Europeans think Hershey bars are the worst. And we're like, we just grew up on Hershey bars.
I love them. And Crunch bars and shit. How can a person not like a Crunch bar? Apparently the chocolate isn't good.
The milk chocolate is delicious. As opposed to any sort of sour dark chocolate.
I don't know if the taste would be sour, is it?
Maybe it's bitter. I think there's bitter. Supposed to be a difference.
You're
there.
Right, bitter.
We have like different taste buds. Some for sour, some for bitter.
My mom called up in a panic over the weekend, and I thought, my dad had died, and call me back immediately, ASAP, it's very important. I called her back, panic-stricken, and she said, what kind of chocolate do you want in your bunny? I'm like, I'm 32. Don't anymore do this.
Stop it with the bunnies.
And don't call me up thinking that dad's dead.
Yeah.
I get very scared because his parents died at the exact age he is right now. 69. So you don't fucking... Yeah, that's right. My daddy will do some fucking... I saw the Viagra in the closet, in the thing. Anyway, I said vanilla, Ron. Vanilla chocolate.
She just finally gave in to it?
Yeah.
Give me a fucking Reese's cup. I don't care.
I was like, well, I guess since we are on the phone...
I think the weirdest thing that they do, though, for Easter is a hard-boiled egg. What fucking kid wants to sit there and eat a hard-boiled egg like an old drunk at a bar?
Oh, all right, kid. Gross.
Find a hard-boiled egg for yourself. You might as well throw a couple pickles in there or some beets.
It's disgusting. And the whole ritual that we have to do of we have to dye our own eggs, mm-hmm. wait till they're fine and they're good to go.
Right.
Then we have to hide them. My dad hides 30 eggs every year, and every year we find 25. So every fucking year, there's 5 eggs that
they're
we
rotting.
Haven't found. And for years, I told my dad, get a clipboard and write down each spot. And he refuses to do it. He's like, Dave, steel trap, memory. I'm like, you don't have a steel
trap.
But
he said steel trap and was pointing at your mom's crotch.
Oh, come on. She's listening. Turn off. Oh,
well, then congratulations.
My dad, when we were starting to get older, my dad didn't want to give up the tradition of hiding Easter baskets, but he knew we were too old to do it. So he would just get like a little individual box of chocolates for each of us and just kind of put those out in the open. It was his way of weaning himself off of hiding candy.
I love when we get to hear fun little tidbits from your family history. We get to know more about you then. Scott, South Carolina.
Hey, guys. Yeah. They don't pasteurize their chocolates in Europe and Australia, and that's why theirs is better than ours. You should taste the difference. It's amazing.
Well, it's an acquired taste, and we were raised on sugary sweet milk chocolate. So maybe our taste buds are just ruined from it. That's all. But it's definitely more of what you would call an adult taste than a children's thing. And we're very childish in this country.
Yeah, well, and the holidays brings out that infantilism much more than anything
Absolutely.
Else.
Absolutely. We're supposed to just be infants. Let's go to Ryan, Minnesota, here on Fez.
Yeah, the nice thing about hard-boiled eggs is we got so many left over, then you can turn them into deviled eggs.
Again, the eggs are always available. If you really wanted to sit around and eat hard-boiled eggs, you can have them every fucking day. And no one ever does. You'll never go over to someone's house. You got any snacks? I'll hard-boil some eggs. We'll sit here and watch the game while we eat hard-boiled eggs. I'm like, who am I, Paul Newman?
But also,
is this the accused? Not the accused. What was his?
Cool Hand Luke.
No, years later.
Oh.
The one that he was fucking lawyer. I think he won the
verdict,
Oscar for
I think.
The verdict.
Yeah.
He would just sit in a bar eating hard-boiled eggs up in Boston. Like a fucking loser. It basically established his character as an alcoholic loser. Because he's eating a hard-boiled egg as he sits there at a bar. Pathetic.
And what people don't understand about the hard-boiled eggs, I don't want to eat eggs that my dad hid in gutter water or, you know, in the fucking grill with grease all over these eggs. Because he hides them in all these places. Under wood chips. Now I'm supposed to eat that for breakfast? No.
You might as well just say, there's some snake parts in there. John, Bama, Ron and Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, Fez, I got a question for you. Other than Halloween, what's the best holiday candy? Easter's pretty up there, right up there, isn't it?
There's so many bad Easter candies. I would say Christmas with the candy canes. You go peppermint, you get the peppermint bark.
Hate it. Hate every one of those things that you just said.
A chocolate Santa's great.
Well, a chocolate Santa is just a fucking ripoff of a chocolate bunny. There weren't any chocolate Santas originally. You were right on with the fucking candy cane. And if a candy cane was so good, why doesn't anybody want a fucking candy cane in March? Because it's fucking awful.
I don't eat it.
I put that same up with candy corn. Again, if it's so delicious, have it some other point of the year. Or those ugly little fucking candy hearts that are disgusting that you get in February.
Oh, those are gross. Poor man's Smarties.
Also, Christmas has the hard ribbon candy, which is great. That's a great flavor.
You ever have any in the summer?
No. No.
No. Why would you, right?
No, it's a Christmas thing.
But no, a Hershey bar is good. You can have it any time during the year.
Yeah.
You don't want to like, well, I can't eat a Hershey bar. It's March. Doesn't even make fucking sense. If something's good, it's good. Hershey's you don't see smart. People going, oh, I only have popcorn in the fall. I wouldn't eat it any other time of the year.
Well, that's why Hershey's smart. They just take their like Hershey Kisses and put them in Christmas colors. That's
bang. Done.
That's thinking.
Then they're done.
That's a smart sell right there. That's a better sell than Earl Douglas selling to Joey Galloway.
First of all, I don't think it was Joey Galloway.
Sold. I think that guy's a receiver.
And he's sitting around fucking saying, and I took a cool 30 for myself.
30 what? 30 G's?
$30.
Oh!
He got 10% off a $300 sale.
All right.
But I just backed him up like I would Corky. I'm like, that's great, buddy. You're the lead singer in the band.
The, coming up on Friday, we got Search, Search, Hurry Up and Search. We will be playing that Friday. Great prize we're giving out. If you want to play along at home, make sure you're following on 202Friends on Twitter.com. Pair of boxing gloves, one signed by boxer Bernard Hopkins, one signed by Roy Jones Jr. We have that set to give out this Friday, and that fight will be Saturday night on pay-per-view. So make sure you're following at 202Friends on Twitter.com for Search, Search, Hurry Up and Search.
Matt in Alabama, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Yeah, I got the all-time worst candy ever. I don't know anybody who likes them.
Go ahead.
Peeps.
Disgusting to me.
They are disgusting. They're the worst candy ever. Why would you invent that shit?
They're all... Any of the holiday-specific candies blow. And we're only acting like we like them out of some sense of fucking tradition. But every one of them are grandmother candies that we don't even like. Jason, Orlando.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, Ron. I think if we're talking about holiday-specific candy, Halloween's the worst for Halloween-specific candy. You got the little nasty candy corns.
Candy corn's awful.
The little pumpkin things and the gross caramels that nobody likes. I mean, Easter is one of the best. Christmas doesn't have much holiday-specific candy, so you really can't go with that. It's just all chocolate.
Well, Fez came up with candy cane, and that's fucking... Seriously, that's they're not true. Good. They're not good.
Yeah, they get all over your hand and your face. It's no good.
You never fucking finish one because they're disgusting.
Yeah.
And then, of course, the Easter candy has really fallen out, other than, like, the big coconut egg, which is disgusting, it really just falls into regular fucking candies, where you can get a Mars bar in your basket. Like, that matters. That's like your mom saying, here's $10, go down to the store, fucking enjoy yourself.
The Brock's candies, they have that bunny basket egg. These things are so horrible. They're real bright colored, if you remember. And then they've got some sort of fake marshmallow filling inside. It's supposed to be marshmallow, but it's really thick and gritty. Like somehow they've kind of sprinkled the coconut inside those things.
Here's Justin in Tennessee.
Got a good Easter candy, but I could eat it year-round. Cadbury cream egg.
Now, that's what started this. Fez hates them.
They burn. It's like they've got battery acid inside of chocolate.
I don't even know what to say to that. You said that a couple times, that it burns you. I never think I got burned by one, but I don't know. I like candy a lot less than when I was a little kid. I just really don't care about it as much. But seasonal candies, I think, are bullshit. If they were any good, they'd made the fucking... this is almost like Dave not making fall ball. If you don't make fall ball, face it, you might as well just join in and become something else, like a poet.
No.
Or now with Dave is doing, becoming a Jew.
I'm not becoming a Jew. I'm celebrating the holiday today. And that fall ball thing, that's on Coach K. That's not on me.
So no bread for you this week?
No, I'll go breadless, but I am not pleased about it because the Jews did not tell me that I couldn't eat bread for a week.
I'm going to do Passover. You can't eat anything risen. So it's like cake, cookie. You're in the South Beach for a week.
I'm not into sweets, so cakes and cookies I'm fine with, but I love bread. I eat at least 2 sandwiches a day.
Not anymore. What kind of sandwich you normally eat?
I make a roast beef. I call it Dave's Roast Beef Special,
mm-hmm.
which is roast beef, oil and vinegar on wheat bread.
All right, and that's called a special?
Dave's Roast Beef
So here's special. What I want you to know.
Yeah.
It's just a plate with you putting the oil and vinegar on the plate and putting the roast beef in it.
Yeah.
That's it. Isn't it weird how somebody that doesn't even sound like food?
No.
Without the bread wrapped around
it's
it?
It's not, because how would I dunk it? Like, I couldn't dunk it. It wouldn't get on the roast beef at the same time.
Well, you want to be a good Jew, and this is the way to do it.
What's their problem with fucking bread? It's fucking pork.
They're the same as fucking Fez. It's all about lettuce wraps at this point on.
Ugh, hate wraps.
Jared, Texas, you're on Fez.
Hey, what about that nasty fucking rock candy, Christmas candy that your grandma used to give you in that metal tin? It's all stuck together and shit.
That's it's grandmother gross. Food. All this is grandmother food. Brian, you're in Ron Fez.
The worst candy has to be the little Easter egg that they sprinkle down in. It falls into the straw. It's shitty chocolate. Plus, it's labor intensive. You have to pull the tin foil off it to eat it.
Yeah, it's awful. Dan, Long Island.
Hey guys. Yeah, I think Valentine's Day, the chocolate covered cherries is the best.
You're a girl. That's girl food.
A Whitman sampler, it's not that great because, you know, half of the fillings you are just not going to like in a Valentine's Day heart of candy.
Yeah, there's nothing good about those samplers. They're not good.
All you can do is
they're grandmother fucking candies.
Maybe hope to find the caramels or the solids.
I'll agree with you on the caramel. I'm not sure where you're going on the solids. Is it like a cream-based?
No, the solids, where it's just...
Oh, just solid candy.
Yeah, where they throw a couple of those in there.
That's a chunky, then. I don't even want it.
Where they try to... it's almost like, we know everyone... It's the first two that anyone's going to go for. The,
Look what is your second biggest fan, Death Metal Mo. Hey, Mo.
Gentlemen, great to hear you as always. 9170 checking in today with you.
Hey, buddy.
Thank you, gracias, buddy. Just to go back to the candy thing, I was lucky enough as a kid to be influenced, I guess, by my grandparents. I'm that asshole that likes all that really old, shitty candy like Mary Jane's and Necco wafers. And
I'm a Mary Jane fan.
Yeah, squirrel nut zippers and sugar daddies, all that old shit. I don't know why, but I just love it.
No, I haven't had a sugar daddy in fucking decades. I forgot they even existed.
I don't even know if they make them anymore,
well,
but I just love that shit.
There is a company, I think they're called Groovy Candy, that sells 1960s candy and 70s, and I think maybe even 80s stuff. And you get this box sent to you. It's pretty expensive.
Yeah.
You're so excited when you get it, and then 15 minutes into it, you're like, I feel queasy. I don't know what it is about these sugar babies, but they're disgusting.
I saw something on Amazon. You can even go back to, like, I think 1920s and 30s selections of candy, if you feel like Red Hot Dollars and all that old shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, true story.
All right, Mo. Peace. There's Mo with some fun facts. Stuff you can get on Amazon.
A lot of that candy you had to really work for, like the candy dots. You're basically biting off paper.
Well, that actually set you up for acid. That was like microdot.
And then the candy necklace, thing's hard as a rock, and you're trying to chew this thing off of your own neck. Like you're a coyote caught in a trap.
What's this?
The candy necklace.
Oh, yeah. It was like the little puka shell necklace.
Right, yeah.
For girls.
It had the elastic string.
You ever see a guy wearing puka shells? Saw it on American Idol. The guy's fucking brother was wearing it.
It's a bad look. Turk Wendell of the Mets, formerly of the Mets, used to have some weird teeth thing.
All the brohans love rocking the puka shells.
What's a brohan?
Frat kids.
Ah.
They love it.
So I even thought the candy necklaces were girl candy. I think for a guy to put on a candy necklace, it's the same as a puka.
Absolutely. That was very girlish.
I thought they were for everyone, like the ring pop. I thought that was for everybody, too, boys and girls.
Boys don't wear rings.
Well, let's see, you just won the championship. Now, what's a ring pop? I don't even know what you're talking about.
That's a plastic ring. You slide it on your finger. It's a lollipop, big giant like gem on top of it, made out of lollipop.
Giant gem of lollipop.
Yeah, where it's just a big piece of candy where you have the ring on your finger and you're eating it like a lollipop.
Fun facts. Here's Dave in New York.
What's going on, boys?
Yeah.
Hey, Fezzy, since you like the candy canes, what's your feeling on those peppermint patties, those York peppermint patties?
Don't like a York peppermint patty. I think it's the dark chocolate. They take the peppermint and they ruin it.
Fez going off right now on one of his patented rants. He's taking on peppermint patty.
Yeah, you take a perfectly good peppermint flavor. You've got the peppermint there. Let's put it in the worst chocolate ever. Really dark chocolate.
Preach, motherfucker. Finally, the truth is coming out. Fez Watley dropping truth bombs on peppermint patty.
The York people should be shut down. I don't even know
Easy
if
Easy now, Fez. They have a right to a business.
I don't know if I see anyone ever buying a York. I don't remember as a kid seeing anyone eat a York peppermint patty.
They had great commercials on a couple years ago where the girls act like they were having orgasms. Just some of the give and take we do here on the Ron and Fez show. Frank. Jackson,
yeah, what about candy cigarettes? Nobody's talking about those.
Candy cigarettes, I don't even know if you're allowed to make them anymore, but they were a great way before you were old enough to look cool to pretend you were cool.
There were two kinds, though. There was the kind that was just a stick with a little red flame on it.
Which actually tasted bad enough that you would have rather just kept it as a cigarette.
Yeah, and then there was the kind that literally was in rolling paper. That was more gum.
That was gum.
That you could blow a puff of smoke.
One puff.
That was like sugar.
Yeah, you had one puff that you could blow.
That I preferred, because those looked like cigarettes.
For 1 second.
Yeah, for 1 second.
But then the paper got wet, gum underneath it, you fucked up the gum.
Yeah, I used to always get those at the beach and pretend like I was some kind of like old writer on vacation.
Then they had the bubblegum cigars too, the pink, yellow, and green.
Steve in Rochester.
Hey, what's going on, Ronnie B? Worst candy ever, dude. You remember circus peanuts?
Those orange peanuts?
Yeah, they're fucking disgusting.
Grandmother fucking peanuts. Grandmother candy also.
They would end up in an Easter basket, but since they came in one big bag, our parents would just throw them into the basket, and they were so soft and melty, you would end up getting that green grass. Melted right into them, that green fake grass.
I'm learning so much about your childhood today, Fez.
The grass would ruin that Easter basket grass would ruin everything.
You didn't like it?
It would get tied into the jelly beans, any loose candy in there. It had green dye left on it from the grass melting.
You didn't like that?
No, I didn't care for it.
Did you ever tell your parents?
No, I don't remember mentioning it.
Send them a clip of this.
Well, now it would just be the box of candy. If they don't even do that anymore.
Why is that? Because you're in midlife now? They don't have anything for you like they used to?
A little bit too old for it now.
See what he's trying to start? I won't go to it, though. See what he's doing to you?
Uh-huh.
What's that?
He's trying to make me out as Andy Rooney.
Sean in Denver, you're on my face.
Yeah, hey, guys. How you doing? You guys ever had, I don't know any of the exact names, have you guys ever had any of the Mexican candy?
No, but I was on a Mexican radio.
Okay, well, Mexican candy. There's one. The only one I can think of is called Lucas or whatever. But
First of all, you bring it up like they make anything better than us. That's just fucking cheating. That's like going, I'm going like this. Oh, you know what's bad? Mexican shoes. Oh. You know what I don't think is good? A Mexican home. Now I miss the Andy Rooney stuff. I won't get caught up in their Andy Rooney. You know what I get mad at Dave for?
What's that?
Going for the joke. Sometimes we just get past history stuff, some statements. We learn more about Fez. I've learned more about you than ever, Fez.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It is the Ron and Fez show. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Jay in Richmond.
Hey, fellas. How's it going? Hey, listen, there's a place in Atlantic City on the boardwalk at the Steel Pier. Right before you go in, there's a little candy shop that sells all retro stuff.
If you're in the Steel Pier, they ain't retro. That's fucking new to them, damn it.
I'm just saying, they got your candy cigarettes.
You know, the Steel Pier was famous for one of the greatest show business things of all time, pushing a horse into the water. They used to take a horse up on this deck, hit it in the asshole with a cattle prod, and have it fall into the water, and they called it the famous diving horse of Atlantic City.
I'd still watch that.
Fuck yeah.
We're not cool enough to animals anymore to, you know, for our own enjoyment. Fucking Pete is a dick.
Well, that's what happens. Pete is like, do you know how many of these horses break their backs every summer?
So?
But you don't understand. Now I get to see a fucking horse going into the water.
That had to be frightening as hell, though. If you're standing there watching the show and you get one of those horses that just comes up lame from the dive.
Well, it had a rider, too. Sometimes the riders would get killed. But in those days, we believed in real entertainment. We didn't have fake entertainment. We were death defiers.
It was on reality TV, just, you know, throwing horses in the lakes.
It kind of was. Come on in here, kids. You'll see a horse go into the ocean and then try to swim its way out. Kids went fucking crazy. They were so happy. All right, we're going to break here. Back in just a couple of minutes.
Yeah, a booking has stopped by. Said Valerie Harper is here if we want to take her on to the show. She's promoting her new she's on a new Broadway show, Looped.
Valerie Harper, of course, from the Mary Tyler Moore, yep. Rhoda. Wow. Yeah, I would love to see her. What is she here promoting?
She's a new Broadway show, Looped. LoopedOnBroadway.com.
I'd love to meet Valerie Harper. Bring her in. Fezzi, you were telling me that while I was talking to Valerie Harper, you had a panic attack?
I went into a major panic attack where my hands started tingling and went numb down my arm.
Did you think that you were on the Mary Tyler Moore show? Is that what happened?
I wish. That would have calmed down my panic.
What set it off?
I have no idea what set this off. There was nothing going on. I just, all of a sudden, I got the shortness of breath, the numbness in my arm, my heart still pounding, and it was just, oh man, it was, my face, my whole body just locks up, and it's like, I feel like I can't get my breath, and then the tears start to come.
What was making you cry, Valerie Harper?
No, it wasn't Valerie Harper. I enjoyed Valerie Harper.
So what brings on the tears? So this isn't anything that happened, anything that you thought. It's just like an overrush.
Right, yeah, where it's like I didn't, you know, there wasn't like a bad experience in the elevator that could do it. You know, there wasn't anything that got me wound up.
Could this signify your elevator trip on the way down?
Oh, well, now I'll be thinking about
it. This is a premonition.
Yeah. Yeah, and it was just, my heart still feels like it's racing. And, oh, it's the most scary feeling, because it feels like I'm going to go down, I'm going to hit the floor.
So did you have it in front of Valerie Harper?
I don't think so. I think...
Went in the other room?
I was in the booth, so I don't think, I could be seen.
Very sweaty in here.
Was he?
Yeah.
Did he say anything to you about it?
No, I could see that he was trying to hold something in.
When he does that, Just push him on his back and start pushing his legs up and down, and maybe he'll spit out the water.
That's what it feels like. There is no air coming in or going out.
Maybe you thought you were a rock for a couple moments.
And then, you know...
It just goes away on its own, right?
And then, well, yeah, eventually, yeah. But the chest locks up so bad that I figure, well, this is it, heart attack or stroke, and or stroke.
Oh, I see.
Where I could possibly have either one. Or both.
You should have told Valerie Harper. Oh, you could have just grabbed the mic, screamed out, I'm having a heart attack. Enough about you and your Broadway goodness.
Let's see what Tallulah Bankhead will do about if she knows CPR.
Tallulah Bankhead, how are you? I might go over and see this. I'll be a Broadway baby. And after that, I'll be out mingling with the stars. A lot of good stuff coming to Broadway. You're not such a Broadway guy, though. Well, you don't like music.
Right.
And then you don't like plays and you don't like reading.
Yeah, so that pretty much cancels out all of Broadway for me. Up and down the Great White Way.
You can sit at your house and have a panic attack. Do you normally have them by yourself or they happen in public like that?
Normally, they're by myself.
Yeah. Well, if it means anything, I didn't notice. Did any of you guys notice he was having one?
I just noticed the sweatiness. It seemed more so than usual.
So, I knew something was wrong because what she said to you, how did you get the name Fez when you were putting her in her chair?
Oh, yeah.
You didn't do your line.
No.
So, he just went like this to Valerie Harper. And he takes his fucking, his shoulders and puts them up to his head, and I go like this. Oh, it's because his dad was a Shriner. His fucking joke, I had to just go filling it in. Because it became, you know.
All I could do at that point was put Valerie Harper in her chair and then run.
Sean, you're a manifest. Sean, Texas.
Yeah. Is the panic attack starting to go away now that we're paying attention to him again?
Sometimes I think that happens, right?
Sometimes it'll work. I know my heart's still pounding.
Daddy loves you. It's just that Valerie Harper came over and I had to talk to her for a while. But you're still my bouncing baby girl. You know that.
Thank you.
Valerie Harper's never going to take you away from me. Plus, you've been in more hit shows than she has. Oh, wait. I was thinking of Carol Burnett. You haven't done anything compared to her.
No. I haven't had hit TV shows.
You think that's a little bit of jealousy with Valerie Harper? Like, having us all look at her?
I am not jealous of Valerie Harper. It's a great role to get to play Tallulah Bankhead, but I'm not jealous of her.
You would have made a good Tallulah Bankhead.
I would have made a fantastic Tallulah Bankhead.
If, just fucking, you know, freaking out when Valerie Harper comes over as the role, yeah. Here's Lynn and Edison, you're on Fez.
Hi, I wanted to tell Fez that I suffer from panic attacks. And I know you feel it's horrible. I'm having one right now, just being on the radio talking. It's the most horrible.
Lynn, I have to go away for a while. I need you to stay on the radio for the next 45 minutes. Can you do that for me?
45 minutes?
Yes, you just keep talking by yourself for the next 45 minutes. And while you're doing that, we're going to put up pictures of you from when you were younger and fatter on the website for people to look at and judge.
Where would you get my picture?
I have ways of getting things, honey. I've got connections in Edison.
Well, I don't have any pictures on. I don't have any pictures in on the website. Sorry. Well,
I just get worried about something. Do you know where everyone in your family is? I just had a bad feeling that maybe somebody got hurt or worse.
Hey. No, I don't know where they are.
Oh, no. This feels like a jinx.
You know what? I'm so, like, thrilled to be talking to you.
Yeah.
I love you.
Yeah. It is fun.
Fez.
Do you see how she said she was having a panic attack and now she's not?
Right, yeah.
You get the same way.
Yeah, you just talked me down from it.
Yeah, you just gotta change your fucking thing to something ridiculous.
Yeah, I was so nervous talking to you at the beginning of the phone call, but you just helped relax me. Like, I went from a 10 to, like, a 5.
Yeah. Now let's see if we can take you back to from a 5 to a 10 and then up to an 11.
I didn't hear that.
Yeah, I know. Fezzi, they're very common. Everybody has them.
As long as you can start getting the air going back in, or at least feel it, you know, you can start to come down.
No, you will come down no matter what. The worst thing that could happen is that you would faint, and then your body would start to breathe on its own. No one dies from a panic attack.
That's true. I'm 50 years old, and I've had them since they started when I was 19, and nothing has ever happened to me. I've never fainted, but I've really been very, I've had a lot of them.
Right.
Nothing ever happened, but, I take, Xanax and it helps me, but, I heard Fez the other day and he can't handle them apparently.
No, I don't do well with the Xanax.
Then I
breathe too much.
Is there anything you feel like you do well with? Anything, anywhere?
Not any pharmaceutical thing.
Mm.
And I can't say booze.
So what do you do well, Nit?
It's the only thing, I did do behavioral therapy where you keep putting yourself in the situation that upsets you, that causes the panic, and that helps. That helps a lot.
You just slowly start and get used to it.
Yeah, it's behavioral therapy. I did that, and that helped me a lot. So, I don't know, that might be something he's interested in. But anyway, I was very happy to talk to you guys. So.
Same here, darling.
All the time.
All right, take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. There goes Lyndon from Edison, who I consider Earth 2 Fez. That's you, Fezzy, if you weren't a woman.
Living in Edison, New Jersey. If a panic attack happens at home, usually what happens is I have to get outside of the home. There's like a little park outside my building.
Oh, Horror Park. I know that place.
Don't call it Horror Park.
What's wrong? I just know that because a couple guys got raped there.
That makes the park a scary place to go to instead of the breathing place.
It's a great place, though, if you have a heart attack and die there, there's plenty of squirrels to eat at your body.
True. Squirrels overrun the place. And that neighborhood, I'm sure I would just get passed by, too.
All right, Ron and Fez show. Fez Whatley back. Just had a little panic attack, and he feels all better. Corey in Tennessee.
Hey, buddies. What's going on?
Yeah.
Fez, instead of randomly roaming through this park that you talk about to get over your anxiety, how about, relax, tuck up a bit, and just clear your mind? I think you're way overdue for that, buddy.
The pot smokers want you, Fez. They want you in.
Rip a bong.
How about a one-hitter for yourself?
Just never did well with pot.
Because you sit down and smoked a lot of pot.
Mm-hmm.
Do it the Tommy Chong way. Get up, 3 hits off it, put it out. That's it. 3 hits and out.
That's all you're going to need.
Let it fucking creep on you from there. But don't fucking sit around and go, wait, it's already creeped, and I'm smoking 15 fucking minutes deep into that. I'm really going to go places. Here's a little bit of a news story. They have canceled 24. And this is a show after 8 years I've never seen one episode of. Well, it isn't canceled. They said they have 24 hours to save it. And the only person that can do this is Kiefer Sutherland. He has 24 hours to pull this out.
So with the amount of seasons they had on, they basically only had a week's worth. Mm. With each season being a day.
But I guess those were big years. Like, that 24, he saved the world every single time, right?
Well, that first season just blew everyone's fucking mind that it was in real time, and everyone just couldn't take it. And it was like, this is the greatest show I've ever seen in my life.
Now, during that 24 hours, does he take a shit?
I don't believe they've ever shown him taking a shit.
Piss?
Piss either. He's just saving shit.
It just can't happen in real time. at some point, you got to take a piss. And hopefully, for the Sutherland family, Keith also needs to fucking pinch the loaf.
It's dangerous not to shit or piss.
And even on these missions, he's got to stop and have a sandwich at some point.
Why not just have one while you're on the toilet? Fucking, you know, kill two birds. Now, Fez, during a 24-hour period, if this was 24, starring Fez Watley, how big would panic, Pat? How much panic time you have to put in?
Out of the 24, I would say there's probably 20 today. There'll be 20.
Why don't you just relax? We got some new age music for him. Does that help you, Fez?
It's okay.
Does this help you relax? You breathe in, you let it out. Breathe the panic in. Hold it. Leave that fear in your chest. Breathe out. I don't see you breathing long.
Yeah, when you said breathe the panic in, I could feel it going in and sitting on my chest, wrapping around my heart like a big chain.
So why don't you just shut your eyes, Fezzy?
All right.
Shut your eyes and put your hands up over your chest. That's it. Just keep your hands on your chest.
Okay.
The same way you will once you're in the coffin.
Oh.
A tight, airless tomb. Just relax and think of that every day that you wake up, you're closer to death. And who knows what will come today or many years from now. And again, what's the difference, since you're going to die either way?
It's not real relaxing.
Take that breath. Think about the shame you've brought on yourself and others. Guilt that you have. Just always remember that the future has no guarantees.
Mm-hmm.
Just chaos. Chaos and cruelty. Try to picture yourself in front of a huge white wall and think how you don't measure up to that wall. And that wall, of course, represents manhood. Mm-hmm. That's you as an adult.
Yeah.
Getting smaller and smaller.
Can't see the top of the wall or the ends of it.
That's because you slacked off and let everything go. Everything that you should have been working on. You worked on the wrong things. Now it's going to catch up with you. And everyone's going to know your failures.
Okay, it kind of feels like the wall's coming down on me.
Much like the building you try to sleep in every night. There's no guarantees. Every moment that you're at rest, disease is growing in your body. Disease doesn't sleep. And unlike you, disease doesn't underachieve.
No, it doesn't stop.
Tom, in Connecticut, you're on Ron Fez.
Yeah, a way for Fez to relax is just to think you'll never have another heart attack because of all the exercise and dieting he's been doing. He's just too fit. It'll never happen again.
That's what makes you safe, Fez. You've known you've done the work. You've prepared yourself to be healthy. That's why you spent 45 minutes today talking about different kinds of candies that you like to suck on. Clot-inducing, stent-pumping fucking candies. Here's David in Virginia. David, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, Fez, I got an idea for you. Have a Davy Mac stand in front of you, and you can blow your load all over him. Help you relax, and he doesn't mind men to come on him.
Would that help you, Fez?
I don't think I would be able to achieve that with Dave standing in front of me.
Dave's down to do that, he just told me.
All right. It's up to him.
They said green light specifically.
Project Green Light.
Are you feeling any better, Fez?
It's all a little tight. It's a little pain in the chest.
That pain you feel is an emptiness where a relationship is supposed to be. Because not only will you die alone, but you'll have achieved nothing and ruined what little time on earth you did have. Take a deep breath and wonder to yourself, how many more chances do I have to breathe before the heart stops, the blood stops pumping, and everything turns black and cold?
See, when I start counting them, then it does feel like a finite number.
Don't think of death as an ending. Think of death as a black eternity where no one can hear your screams, your lonely screams of panic. Jeff in Long Island, you're on with Fez.
How are you guys?
Good.
Fezzy, I got a question. You have some stents, right, buddy?
Yes, sir.
Are you on Plavix?
Yes, I am.
Are you aware that there's a new change with Plavix and that it doesn't work for everybody and that you could possibly have another heart attack and be dead?
No, I was not aware of that.
Tells you know so much about you.
But I did already have the second one after the after I started taking the Plavix.
Start thinking of yourself, Fezzy, as your own death. That way you can own your own death and just become death itself.
Well, nobody likes death.
But you're going to spend more time being dead than anything else. Anything that you will ever do, you'll be dead longer. Here is here's Chris, New Hampshire.
Yeah, I think I can help him out.
Sure.
Maybe rub a little lotion on his chest, comb his hair.
Fez, it puts the lotion on its skin, or else it gets the hose again.
Are you a great big fat person? Give me back my dog!
None of this working for you? I can't even drag you into this.
No, not even. Thinking about being caught in a deep pit in an old nightgown for whatever reason does not. It's not the visualization that's getting me past the panic.
Well, I don't know what to do for you, folks. We've tried. Take your music down. You tell us what you need. We'll just listen.
Yeah, it just feels like I need some air. Where, like, it's the air is not making its way through to the lungs and the circulatory system and the heart. Where all of a sudden just some big gasp. Still very, still really shallow. I think it's coming back. Because I'm supposed to focus on... supposed to focus on the breathing, but that doesn't work.
You seem like you liked it better when we were just being silly or having fun.
My head is just spinning right now.
Why don't you take a little walk around? You weren't upset when we were doing the jokes about it.
No, No, it's like
the second we stopped.
I started talking about air and like did it to myself.
Well, again, we talked about it. Nothing bad can happen to you, right?
Right.
Now what, your own shrink? So what has your shrink taught you how to beat this thing? What are you supposed to do?
What I'm to breathe, okay. And I'm not getting it done.
Here's Steve. You're on my face.
It's a warm cup of jizz or milk.
Oh, stop with that! You see, the guy's having a tough time. Fez, would you grab that for me too and fix those levels? Fix the levels, please.
I'm sorry, fix what?
The levels. John in Oklahoma City.
Yeah, Fez, I've got an idea for you. It may seem a little drastic, but I'm wondering if you've ever entertained the idea of medically induced amnesia. You could just wipe your whole brain clean. Start fresh.
I'm willing to do that with you. Here's Michael. In Texas.
Hey, Ronnie, I think you need to help Fezzy out. Give him a cigar. Have a cigar, Fezzy, and relax.
You ever had cigars, Fez?
Not on any sort of regular basis.
You like the feeling?
I do like the feeling, yeah. Yep.
What do you like about it?
I think what I like is that, I think it is the breathing aspect of it.
Yeah, it's a nice relaxing breath.
Where it can go, you know.
And it doesn't taste as bad as air. You get a nice cigar taste to it. Nice tobacco taste.
And it's something to keep you occupied, too.
Occupied for what?
Like, just, it's something to do with your hands.
I find it hard to believe that as long as you've been in therapy, you don't have anything to go to when a panic attack is coming on. This is your second today.
Uh-huh.
And you seem like a guy, this is the first time you've ever had them.
I know what I'm supposed to do, and when it comes up, I can't make it happen.
What are you supposed to do?
I'm supposed to give it a shape and a color, and, you know.
Well, what shape are we giving this?
It feels like a big circle.
Like what color?
Blue.
I'm
like a light blue, and it's like, and I'm supposed to.
Well, wait, but by circle, is it more of an oval? Because I'm getting more of an oval shape. And I'm not even getting blue as much as I'm getting turquoise.
No, I'm getting like a perfect circle. With,
how far back away from you?
It's like right here.
Well, push it back to where I am, and you'll see it's a fucking oval. If from there, it's an oval, and it's more turquoise.
Yeah, I see it as light blue.
Where
like
is
a
it
really
now?
Light blue. It's like, it's there, but it's like as far back as your hand
is. We'll move it even further back. And you can see the difference. Now, how could it be all the way over there? You're not. What color do you see it as?
Greenish.
All right, so greenish. Dave?
Could I combine turquoise and greenish? Maybe a tuginish color? Because that's
what
I'm seeing.
Is there even a color to that?
I don't know that color.
And what shape do you guys see?
Murky.
Mine's more of a round cube.
Well, you can't be round in a fucking cube.
That's how Zeth sees it.
It sounds like an egg-shaped thing, then, for you. Here's Mark in Georgia. You're on Run of Fez.
Hey, I feel a little cheated. I want to hear more about Valerie Harper and how she's holding up.
She looks fantastic.
She looks really good.
She looks wonderful and is just the sweetest person.
She looks like Valerie Harper.
Exactly like it. It's like it's 1970 and she's playing Rhoda.
She hasn't changed a bit.
She kind of reminds you of Beanie a little bit.
Well, her and Beanie would probably be about the same age. It seems like they had their Broadway dreams at the same time. Only one of them made it.
Yeah, I mean, my mom wasn't exactly on the Mary Tyler, you know, Moore show.
Your mom had four unwanted pregnancies.
Making her much different than Valerie Harper.
How you doing over in the office?
I'm okay. I'm getting there.
Did you say you're MLK? Because you might be really having a meltdown.
I tried to say I'm all right and I'm okay at the same time, and it came out I'm MLK.
Why are you upset today? What happened?
I have no idea. This is...
Everything was great till Valerie Harper. You were talking about candy. You were giving us fun facts from when you were younger.
Mm-hmm.
I stopped Dave from playing the clock. Wait a minute, Dave did play the clock music today. So you did push off that that fucking last panic attack.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It seemed like from pushing it back and finally seeing it at its true color, turquoise and not light blue.
That's what I'm supposed to do. It's so hard to do, though, when I...
But you did it.
Yeah.
How come you don't celebrate that?
Because I didn't think to do it the first time. Like, the idea was there, and it's like... It flashes right past me.
Hmm. So why don't you have it on a piece of paper? So every time you start to have a panic attack, you can go into your wallet, read out your little instruction form.
I've done that before, and it's like I've taken it and just... It's just... all those things
nothing
I
can
know,
help you.
All those things I know.
You can't be
and
helped.
I
do,
and it's like I've done that before where I've had the paper and just my hand shaking so bad it goes right back in the pocket where it's like I'm trying to let me get the next breath and then maybe I can get to the piece of paper or maybe I can get to the visualization.
Mm. So you will always blame Valerie Harper. I wonder now like if you'll ever see the Hogan family and start to feel like panic seeing that woman on there.
I'll only be able to watch the Sandy Duncan episodes. Up to the skies. Things like that drive me out of my mind.
I watched it for a little while. I like to watch that. All right, that's it for us. Scale 1 to 10, how you feeling, big man?
A 4.
That's pretty good.
It's breathing.
It's breathing. Well, like you said, you're always going to breathe no matter what happened. Satellite's gone way up to Mars. It's good. I'm happy for you. All right, that's it for us.